we're going to give you the final step to stress mastery. So as we started this journey together, we talked about stress mastery as peace. And these steps are designed for you to overcome lower consciousness, survival energies. And it starts with step one, your diet. You must get the sugar out of your diet, and you must manage the stress response. It's a physiological hormonal response that is never shut off. You cannot shut it off, you can only manage it. And if your diet's not dialed in, especially as we get older, there's no way you manage stress. You can sit on the mountain and meditate till the cows come home. You are not gonna manage it, because the diet manages the response, which manages the nervous system. And it's about living in the green zone. We go into step two, exercise. Exercise is a little bit different. We talked about muscle. This program of stress mastery is about raising your energy, your consciousness level, the level you live in. We all have a consciousness we live in. Well, this is energy. If your body's not strong and can't handle the rise of energy, you will fall back into the lower energies. So that's what happens to many people. You can be on this spiritual quest. You can be on this quest to find self-awareness. If your body's not strong enough to handle your new state of consciousness, you will fall. So exercise is all about keeping the muscle and the body strong so you can rise. It's movement. Number three, we started entering personal development with naming the ego. This is when you create your first separation and you become born again. And you start to realize by naming your ego, you're not the voice in your head. And so it's the first real personal development. You can try personal development all you want, but if you're still not understanding that there's a voice in your head that's going off all day long, then you're going to be very frustrated with self-sabotage and procrastination. Then we go to step four, very important step, and it's about letting go. It's the technique of releasing these old programs of the ego. See, your self-concept, everybody lives their life through the cage of their beliefs. The sum of your beliefs is who you think you are. It's your life. That's a truth. It's your life. If you change the sum of your beliefs, you change your life. Now, many of us have been programmed. Let's say that. I scratch that. All of us have been programmed for survival, to survive in our particular tribe. But the challenge is that these programs are homeostatic. They're designed never to change. So your subconscious doesn't know the difference between a good program and a bad program. It just reacts to the program. It's like your computer. Your computer doesn't know a virus is bad. It reacts to the virus. And in that, so that's the importance of this step. So letting go is about self-awareness. It's about you separating yourself from ego and seeing the program and doing the technique to blow the program out. If you have a predominant program in you of anger and you get rid of the program anger, you cannot get angry again. It's impossible. So that's the way our mind works, like a computer. Understanding your smartphone is you try to jailbreak your smartphone. Not many people can. And it's the same with the mind. Many people cannot jailbreak their operating system of their subconscious mind because they don't understand how it works. These steps will take you right through that process. So that was when we talked about. Then we came to step five, where the Green Focus Power Hour. And I hope you guys have been doing that. It's going to be very uncomfortable when you start. You're going to hear your ego loud and proud. And it's very important that you get through 30 days. In creating self-awareness and change, there are four testing periods that happen when you go to reset the operating system. So here we are, we decide we're gonna do the Green Focus Power Hour, and we have to get up an hour early. But we're programming our mind to sleep till 6, but now we have to get up at 5, because we wanna do this. Immediately, what's gonna happen, you may go a couple days, but then you'll have what's called a snapback. And that snapback is your subconscious bringing you back to your habit or to your program. See, it doesn't know why you're getting up at 5 a.m. The subconscious doesn't work that way. Think of it as a computer. So here are your testing periods. 30 days. You must get through 30 days or you can't change. You have to create accountability, get a coach, get a mentor, find somebody, get a friend, But you have to go through 30 days. After 30 days, the cage expands and the green focus power now becomes easy. You're getting up at 5, everything's good, it's going. Then you'll come to the second testing period. From the time you started, the second testing period is a 12-week mark. In the diet world, this is when people hit plateaus and they sabotage themselves. When you hit that 12-week mark, okay, you have to be ready for it because it's going to snap you back and eventually you go back to your old habit of sleeping till 6 o'clock. Get through that, you get to the six-month test. The six-month test is always interesting because in the six-month test, you now have accomplished things. But what happens is, like in the diet world, you've lost your weight. Now what? You must make sure at 6 months that that picture we talked about in the cage is the life that you want. Because if you don't, and for instance in weight loss, if you're a thin person looking in the mirror at this thin person, but in your mind, you're that overweight person, you will snap back to being the overweight person. Always. You'll sabotage yourself unconsciously. You see it happen in money. Athletes that make a lot of money will snap back and be broke because they don't have the money within the operating system. Okay? Then the 1 year mark is the final test. After 1 year, you reset the cage. And that is what's called willpower, blind will. I don't have to think about exercising. My exercise program is set in the cage. That means I can say, well, I'm going to get up in the morning, I'm going to exercise, and in the cage, the orders are done. Yes, we're going to get up and exercise. It takes a year, 1 year to set that cage. So that's what the Green Focus Power Hour is doing for you. It's the beginning. Then you progress to step 6, and that is meditation. And we talked that meditation is about developing the other muscle, the muscle of concentration, being able to release the deep programs of the wants, the wanting to belong, the wanting of approval, the wanting of security, and the want of control. Then we come to step 7. We're done. In step 7, you are now living stress mastery. For those that really get to step 7, their whole life has changed. And they're now following a spiritual practice that everybody should follow. And it's 3 steps in this spiritual practice. Step 7 of stress mastery is called finding the now. And the spiritual 3 steps are 1, live in the present, be in the now. It's very important because it's the only thing that's real. When you're in the now, you're in the green zone, you're connected to God. That's it. So what happens is, that's our intention, and that's what every spiritual practice teaches you. But here's the thing. Step 1 is living in the now, being present. Step 2 is self-awareness. What does that mean? To know when you're not in the present, and to be able to use the techniques you've learned to let it go. Because if you're not in the present, your ego has either pulled you to the past or pulled you to the future. It's that self-awareness to know, wait a minute, what's going on inside there? Barry, why are you so upset? What's pulling me out? Because that is huge. Because in that second step, you now have the ability to let go what pulled you out. Remember, if you remove the program, you can never experience it again. And then step 3 of your spiritual practice in finding the now is surrender. Understanding that you need to surrender. Here's the secret to all success in finding self-awareness. You need to relax. It's an art. You relax. You've done all the work in these steps. I guarantee you cannot fail. But you have to relax and let it take place. Stop living in a power of force, this lower energy. And that is step 7 of stress mastery, of finding a now. It's about being present, having a self-awareness when you're not present, and releasing that energy and surrendering back to the now. It has been my distinct pleasure to present the 7 steps of stress mastery. And I would really like to thank everybody at Elevating Beyond, my good friend, Mark Menard, for allowing me this opportunity to work with him. I'm very excited, and I know, if you follow these steps, you will soon not only develop self-awareness, but develop a peace beyond explanation. Stay inspired.